Hope you're fine at your home and enjoying our digital school. I, Priyanka Kumari from Advocate Papu Sai Bonde High School. I'm your subject teacher for English 2. Our book's name is English Learners English Grammar Book 2. Today we are going to continue the same topic 6 punctuation. Page number 11 part 2. So children, before starting the further, we will revise the previous punctuation marks. Capital letters. We use capital letter for beginning proper nouns. What is proper noun? Proper noun is a special name of a person, place, animal or thing. We also use it at the beginning of a sentence. And I also will always be capital wherever we use. Full stop. We use full stop at the end of a meaningful sentence. Whenever a sentence is complete, we'll give full stop. Comma. We use comma when there are additional details to be mentioned in a sentence. We use it when a sentence has to be continued after a big pause. It is also used to separate two sentences. Like whenever we use more than two sentences, we say orange, apple, banana. So we don't give the pause. We are saying continuously. But when we use the comma, we say like apple, orange, banana, and etc. So children, we are going to learn today another 3 punctuation marks. Now we will learn when and where to use the following punctuation. Now children, we will see the symbol of the other 3 punctuation marks, exclamation or exclamatory. This is the exclamation mark. Now we'll see question mark. Whenever we ask the question, we use this mark, and this is question mark. Open and close inverted comma. Open and close inverted comma, where we see in the stories. So now in detail we'll learn what is exclamation or exclamatory mark. We use exclamatory mark when we express a feeling or surprise like wow, hooray, Allah, alas, etc. These are the expressions and words. Example, I have hurt my foot. But in the example, you can see here we have not used any marks. So it is not looking complete and it is not correct. Now what we'll do here? We'll do it with punctuation mark. This is exclamation mark. I have hurt my foot. This is one complete sentence. So we are using your full stop. Now we'll go to next example. Wow, what a pretty dress. But here we have not used the exclamation mark. So we'll correct it and we'll use it with punctuation mark. Wow. Here after wow, the marks we can see that is exclamatory marks. After exclamation mark, one new sentence is going to start. So we are starting with capital letter. W is capital letter and what a pretty dress. This is a complete sentence. So we are using a full stop. Okay children. Now we'll go to next topic, question marks. We use question mark when we ask question and expect an answer. So children, where you listen more questions? Whenever teacher teaches you, see, ask you many questions. So now here we'll understand with example, where do you live? But here we cannot find what they're giving answer or they're questioning. In answer, we'll correct it and we'll write it with punctuation mark. Where it is starting, so W will be in capital letter. Where do you live? This is the question. So this is at last what mark we have given, that is question mark. Now we'll go to second question. Why have you come so late today? This is looking like one complete sentence, but we are not able to find out which type of punctuation marks we are going to use here. And we'll read the sentence and according to that, we'll find out what we can use here. Why is starting of sentence? So W will be capital letter. And why have you come so late today? This is a question. So at last we'll put question marks. Okay, children. Now we'll go to next topic, open and close inverted commas. We use open and close inverted commas when direct speech is used in the sentence. Example, the old man said, please help me. It is looking like one complete sentence, but it is not complete sentence. One old man. It is a one sentence and please help me. It is another speech. Old man is saying someone to help me. So we'll use the punctuation marks and we'll understand what is and what they're trying to do here. The is the starting of a sentence, so T will be capital letter. Old man is a small complete sentence, so we are giving a small pause, so we are using a comma. Now we are using for another speech, so we are going to close it with the inverted comma. We are opening your inverted comma. Please help me. Old man is asking for help and he is saying please help me. It is a direct speech. So here we are using inverted commas. We are opening the inverted comma. Now please help me is a complete sentence. So we are giving a full stop. Okay. And when this sentence is complete and please help me is a one complete speech. So we are keeping it in a one inverted commas and we are closing the inverted commas. So children, can you tell me how many punctuation marks we have used in this example? Yes, capital letter 1, comma 2, inverted comma 3 and full stop 4. We have used in this 4 punctuation marks. Now we'll go to next and we'll understand what is speech, direct and indirect speech. What is speech, children? This expression of thoughts in spoken words called speech. Whenever you are talking to your friends, you are saying something, what you are thinking, you are telling to your friends, you are expressing your words to your friend, that is called speech. What is direct speech? Direct speech is report of exact words used by speaker or writer. What is mean by speaker or writer? When two person is talking and one person is listening and another is talking, so who is talking? That first person is speaker and who is listening or writing, that is writer. Second person is writer. So here indirect speech means that a report of exact word used by the speaker, like teachers told you, please children write the poem. So what you do, you exact write the poem. So that is direct speech. Indirect speech means indirect speech is reporting the matter that speaker has said. So it is not exactly the same word used by the speaker or writer. Understand what is in this. If you are telling your friends, okay, friends, tomorrow you come and you ask your mama to give you some sweets. You will go and tell your mama, ki mama, I want some sweets for my friends. That is indirect speech because you are conveying the first person message to third person. Now children, we'll do quick revision of the topic punctuation mark. Capital letters, we use capital letter of beginning proper nouns. We also use it at the beginning of a sentence. Full stop, we use full stop at the end of a meaningful sentence. comma. We use comma when there are additional details to be mentioned in a sentence. We use it when a sentence has to be continued after a big pause. It is also used to separate two sentences. Exclamation or exclamatory mark. We use exclamatory mark when we express a feeling or surprise. Question marks. We use question mark when we ask question and expect an answer. Open and close inverted commas. We use open and close inverted commas when direct or indirect speech is used in the sentence. Thank you, children. I hope you are staying safe at your home. Stay safe. Take care. Please like the video, subscribe the channel, and don't forget to press the bell icon.